Good morning, student. Today I am going to teach about MySQL. In this chapter, we have to study about introduction of MySQL, processing capability of SQL, data definition language, data manipulation language, and SQL processing. So first of all, we have to know about SQL. So SQL is a structured query language, and that language provides a facility to work on MySQL. And what is the meaning of MySQL? MySQL is a type of RDBMS software that provide a facility to work on databases. What is the meaning of the database? Student, database is collection of interrelated records. And next is processing capability of SQL. Students, SQL provide different type of the processing capability. First, data definition language, and this data definition language provide a facility to work on database and the SQL. And by using this in DDL, we can create the schema of tables, indexes, and the modifying relation schema, means table structures, table definition. And next is interactive data manipulation language. SQL DML includes the query language based on both relational algebra and the tuple relational calculus, means in the relational algebra we have to define insertion, delete, and modify about the tuples and the relation. And third is embedded data manipulation language. The student, this command category provide a facility to work on SQL or MySQL with the Python or Java. And we can also work on COBOL, Fortran, Pascal, and C. Means SQL provide a facility to embed that syntax and that programming with the other programming language, so we can develop connectivity program. And next is view definition. View definition means view provide a simple security purpose, and that provides certain parts of the database so that database security will be maintained. And next is authorization. Students, SQL also provide the authorizations. Authorization means rights for working on SQL. Integrity. Students, you already knowing about the on the database we can provide a certain restriction. For example, if we want to provide, we can't use or feed duplicate value, but this is possible in the database by maintaining the primary key. And next is transaction control. The student, this transaction control provide a facility to execute more than one command, but it is possible when we include more than one command in the transaction control. And transaction control provide a facility to execute all commands or none, means when the transaction will be successful, means all commands whatever executed in the transaction control block will be executed successfully, otherwise partial parts will be not executed. And data definition language, I have just explained that by using the data definition language we can create the definition and modification on the table or the database. And student, second topic on the data manipulation language means DML, data manipulation language. So this command category provide a facility to work on table contents, means inside the table, means row. By using this command we can retrieve the row records and delete and the update on the record means row. And next is SQL processing. Student, by using the SQL processing we can work on MySQL software. And SQL actually consists of three sub languages: DDL, DML and TCL. I have just explained about the working of DDL and the DML. And next is DCL, data control language. Data control language provide a facility to give the permissions and revoking the permission from the users. Just suppose that we have to give a permission to users so that user can configure database records and also create the user. So we have to give the permission by using the DCL commands. And when we realize that person is misusing the records, then DBA, database administrator, also has right to revoke that permission from that particular user. And next topic is concept of data types. The students already knowing about the data types. What is the meaning of the data types? The student, data type provide a facility to which type of the value will be stored in a particular columns. And there are many types of database. There are many type of the data types such as text, numeric, small int, float, real and double precisions. So these are the data types. Char means character, and the varchar also. So char is the fixed length and varchar is the variable length. And these are the numeric data types like decimal, numeric, int, small int. So what is the meaning of the small int? So suppose that we have to store only person age. So that person age will be in the smallest digits, smallest integer value. In that case we can give small int. Next is float data type. So that data type provide a facility to store integer along with the decimal value. And real is also like a float data types. And double, its capacity is more than floats, and it also provides a facility to store more precision value. And these are the data types for the date and the times. So these are the standard, international standard organization. So this format is first year, month and date. And next is Japanese industrial standard, year, month and the date. And IBM European standard, this format is dd.month.year. And next is IBM USA standard, this format is month, date and the year. This format is also applicable in our country. Various SQL commands and the function. The students, in the SQL there are many commands for work on the records. There are many commands. The first command is create table commands. And by using this command we can create the definition of a database and the table also. At the time of database definition we have to write create database and database name, but in this syntax we can only create the tables. And its syntax is create table and table name. And after that we have to give the data type. students. I will discuss next topic in the next video. Bye.